You know how I am. I don't like to mess around.
The Philosopher's Stone. I found it.
What?
Misty, you took my homunculus, didn't you? I'd like it back if you don't mind terribly.
Is emitting magical energy. There are some sort of glyphs engraved on the walls. But these are runes? It can't be. The 4th and 14th runes, and even the 22nd. These were thought lost forever. What can this mean? Ah. They've already been dispelled. If he has the ability to shift such a huge tower into another dimension, just how powerful is he?
Thank you.
This might be useful for a practice autopsy, at least.
Reality is so boring. I'd choose to sleep forever if it didn't mean I'd never stop dreaming.
Thank you. Odin used to be a rather weak god indeed. So then, how did he manage to become Lord of the Gods? Did you never wonder that, Misty?
Well, now that you mention it...
Humans are incomplete beings. Gods, then, can be considered the final evolution of man. In other words, gods do not grow, but are static. However...
Odin was different, because he's a half-elf.
That's right. Because Odin's divine blood was mixed with mortal, he has the ability to grow, just as we humans do. Combining the finest traits of all beings, Odin was finally able to secure the throne. Now this is where it gets interesting. Gods use the vessels we call elves to travel through Midgard to protect the World Tree.
You're repeating yourself, Lizard.
Listen well, Misty. It's possible to transfer human souls into elves. There it is, conclusive proof that gods and human souls are roughly equivalent beings.
So you're talking about moving souls from one body to another?
Do you know what my homunculi are crafted from?
They're half-elf, half-human.
Correct. My homunculi are essentially half-elves. If I were to shift my soul into the body of a homunculus, might I not become a god?
Would you care to journey with us?
Me? With you?
Yes. Also, if you should join us, it may be possible for you to research Bifrost and Yggdrasil.
Fine. I'll come with you. I mean, it's not as if I really have any other choice, do I?
Indeed.
And you don't have to tempt me with stupid promises either. Besides, it might be fun to haunt that little freak.